Hello friends, I am Dr. Vijay Prakash and today my topic is dyes and dye system in fixed prosthodontics. Now we all know that we need to make an accurate impression because if we don't have an accurate impression, it is not possible to give accurately fitting casting. And to have an accurately fitting casting, all the steps after impression, they are equally important. So once you have made an accurate impression, after that you pour it with your dye stone or appropriate material, that is the dye material. And on the dye, you are going to make wax pattern, and this wax pattern is then casted. So the role of the dye and dye systems cannot be overemphasized because they are one of the very important part. Because if you don't have a proper accurate fitting dyes, then definitely your wax pattern will not be accurate and definitely your casting will also not be accurately fitting. So let us see what are the steps in short. So once you have done the preparation in the patient's mouth, then you are going to make impression. So once you have the accurate impression in front of you, after that you are going to pour a dye. That is, you can pour with a gypsum product or you can use any other type of dye materials. So then what is a dye? A dye by definition is the positive reproduction of the form of a prepared tooth in any suitable substance. Now what are requirements of a dye which is used in fixed prosthesis? One, it should accurately reproduce the teeth or the tooth which has been prepared. It should have a good strength and it should be resistant to abrasion. It should reproduce details accurately and it should be easily wetted by the wax. Also, it should not stick with the wax and should be available in color contrast to the wax which has been used. Another thing is it should be easily mounted onto the articulator, and the prepared surfaces and the unprepared surfaces should be recorded accurately. So these are the requirements of the dyes which we want to use. So what is the classification of dyes which are commonly used in dentistry? Based on the type of material, they are gypsum products, which is, as I told you, the type 4 dental stone, which is most commonly used. Type 5 can also be used. Then you have metal. They can be electroform dyes or sprayed metal, or even amalgam can also be used. And you have polymers. In this, you have epoxy resins and polyurethanes, and divestment material can also be used for the direct baking of the porcelain crowns or refractory dyes for wax patterns. And cements are also used as dyes, like the silicophosphate cements. So the most commonly used dyes in fixed prosthodontics is the gypsum products. So the most commonly used dye is the type 4 and type 5 type of gypsum products, which are used as a dye material. And these materials are capable of reproducing a 20 micron wide line according to ADA specification number 19. They have poor resistance to abrasion and are brittle in nature. But they have number of advantages. That is the reason why they are commonly used, because they have a fairly good dimensional accuracy, as I told you, and they're easy to manipulate. They're economical. They have good strength. They have adequate working time. They can be trimmed easily. They also have a good color contrast, and they're compatible with all impression materials, and they also have a smooth and a hard surface. So these are all the advantages. Because they are having poor resistance to abrasion, you can always add resin. You can use resin strengthened gypsum products, which will take care of the wear resistance. Also, after pouring the impression on the dye, you can apply a low viscosity resin such as cyanoacrylate to improve the resistance to abrasion. And to provide space for the cement, you need to provide a dye spacer which is applied on the dye stone, that is the dye, so as to provide space for the cement. Also, before we make the wax pattern, we have to apply some kind of dye lubricant over the dye stone so that it is easy for the wax pattern removal. Another type of dye material are the epoxy resins, which are supplied in the form of paste, to which we add a liquid activator, and this is added to initiate hardening. Now, the hardened resin is having more wear resistant than the dye stone, and also they have higher strength than the dye stone material. And these materials, they can be supplied in the form of auto mixing systems. There, it is similar to what we use in your light body material, which is supplied in the form of cartridge, and you inject it into the impression. So you are going to inject the epoxy resins into the impression directly with the auto mixing systems. These auto mixing systems are fast setting type, and as you are going to inject it into the impression, they set within the few minutes, and you can fabricate wax pattern after 30 minutes. Also, since the water retards polymerization of resins, it should not be used in impressions which are water containing, such as agar or alginate impression material. Also, it is very much effective with rubber based impression materials, but they are not compatible with polysulfide impression materials. The advantages of this type of resins is they have high strength, they have good abrasion resistance, and the drawback is the complex technique. It is time consuming, the chances of polymerization shrinkage is there, and they are more expensive than the gypsum products. Next type of dye material is the electroplated dyes or electroformed dyes. Now, these electroformed dyes possess moderately high strength, they have good hardness, and they have excellent abrasion resistance. That is the good thing about this material, and it is used to overcome the poor abrasion resistance of the stone dyes, that is, which we use with the dye stone. They can be silver plated or copper plated dyes, and this technique involves deposition of coat of pure silver or copper on the impression, and also the individual pipette to the full arch impression can be electroplated. So advantage of this material is they have excellent abrasion resistance, as I told you before, and they have high strength, but the drawbacks are it is time consuming, it requires special equipments, and also cyanide solution, which is used in silver plating, is extremely toxic, and very importantly, they are not compatible with all impression materials, especially the silicone impression materials. Silicone impression materials are difficult to electroplate evenly because of their low surface energy, and you have the polysulfide impression materials, which can be silver plated, but they cannot be copper plated. It is very difficult to do that. Polyether impression materials, since they are hydrophilic in nature, they have a tendency to imbibe water, and also the hydrocolloid impression materials are very, very difficult to electroplate, and should not be done in such type of impression materials. So they are not compatible with most of these impression materials. Color contrast and adaptation of wax is not as good as in the dye stone material. So these are some of the commonly used dye materials in fixed prosthodontics. Now we will see what are the various dye systems which are used in fixed prosthodontics. The dye systems can be classified on the basis of their design, which can be working cast with a separate dye, one, and working cast with a removable dye. So there are two main classifications. In working cast with a removable dye, there are four types. That is double pin systems, which can be straight or curved, or the Pindex system, the dialog system, and the Accutrace systems. So let us see each of these dye systems one by one. So you have the working cast with a separate dye. Now in this method, either we take two impressions, two separate impressions are made, or you You can use a single impression and it is poured twice to get two separate cards. Now, one cast is poured first from the impression which is used to make the die, and the other cast is poured, that is the second cast which is formed, is the working cast. So you're going to first remove the first cast, that is sections, to form the die, and the other cast is used as a working cast, and the wax pattern is fabricated on the sectioned cast, and this wax pattern is then transferred onto the working cast, that is the working model, and that is checked for the fit of the wax pattern on the working cast. So this system is called as the multiple pour system, because same impression you are pouring multiple times in order to get two types of casts. The advantages with this technique is that this technique is simple and easy to use, and you don't require any special equipments. Also, as the gingival tissues are left intact, they can be used as a guide to make the accurate restoration. The drawbacks of this technique is there are chances of distortion of the wax pattern during transfer from the sectioned die to the working cast, because definitely the chances are you can damage the wax pattern while removing and then again fitting it onto the working model. Secondly, it is difficult to transfer a fragile wax pattern, as I told you, and seating of the pattern on the cast can be difficult, as the second port cast is slightly larger than the first. So the first cast in which you are making a pattern, that may not fit at all on the second cast, because secondly, when you are pouring the impression, it may result in a slightly larger cast. So definitely this type of die system is not recommended. So the more popular one which is used commonly in practice is the removal die systems, and the manipulation here is of the wax pattern is easy, and you don't have to transfer the wax pattern from the die to the working model. The ideal requirements of a removal die system is that dies should be stable, and the working cast with the dies should be easy to mount on the articulator, and also the die should be replaced accurately in the position which is originally occupied. So the various removal die system, as we told you in the classification, they are the double pin system, Pentax system, dialogue system, and the AccuTrack system. So first, the double pin system. They can be of two types. One is the straight double pin system, another one can be the curved double pins. So first, the straight double pin system. Now the double pins, which in these double pins are straight, they are tapered flat sided pins, which is made up of brass, as you can see in the figure, and these are done to resist the horizontal displacement, and their double pins is positioned over the prepared tooth, and there are two techniques of using this type of double pin system. One is the pre-pour technique, another one is the post-pour technique. Now let us see what is the pre-pour technique. In this technique, the double pins are positioned over the prepared tooth, and they are stabilized using a wire clips or a bobby pins, as you can see, and they can be joined with the help of sticky wax. The impression is then poured with die stone till the area which covers the tooth part of the impression. The double pin should never touch the impression, that is very important, and it should be always positioned parallel to the long axis of the prepared tooth. Also, if you have multiple teeth, then all the prepared teeth, they should be all parallel. That means the pin should be parallel to each other. And once the die stone has set, the bobby pins are removed, and you can place a small wax over the tip of the double pin. So you can place a small wax, ball of wax over the double pin, or you can also have a plastic sleeve, which you can see on the left hand side, which is placed over the exposed double. So once you apply the separating media around the double to aid in easy separation of die from the working model, and then you do a second pour with the die stone. After setting of the stone, the cast is removed from the impression, and the dies are sectioned with a thin saw blade. So you have the die stone model and you have the working model, and then you are sectioning the dies with the help of saw. And once you have done that, then you remove the double by just removing the backs or just tapping from behind the double in order to remove the section die. So you have this type of section die which is removed from the model. Another technique in straight dowel pin system is the post pour technique. In this technique, the impression is poured till the level of the teeth, and then you drill a hole once the stone is set in the approximate area of the prepared teeth. And then after that, you are going to cement the dowel pins with the use of cyanoacrylate into these holes. So in this technique, as you can see the die, you just pour the entire impression and then you drill holes into that and then cement the dowel pins into the with the help of cyanoacrylate into the die. The remaining steps for the post-pour technique is same as those we described for the pre-pour technique. And also you have the curved double pins. So apart from the straight double pin system, you have the curved double pin system. This technique is followed by using curved pins, as you can see, and the steps are similar as we have used, we have just seen in straight pins. And the difference here is the curved double pins, they project from the base of the cast, and after sawing the die is removed by just pressing the curved double exposed with the flat ended instrument. So this becomes easy. You don't need to apply any your plastic sleeve or wax. So this is, you just tap it with an instrument and the section die is then removed easily. Next type of system is the Pindex system. It is also called as the reverse drill press system. It is, once you have poured the impression, like in the post-pour technique, the first poured cast is placed on the work table of the Pindex drill. As you can see, a cast is there, and the prepared tooth is positioned below an illuminated red dot. So you position the prepared tooth right below the dot. You have a light beam detector on the top, which you can see there. And it will give red dot, that is, it will emanate red light, and you place the prepared tooth over that red dot. And once the machine is on, you will press this this platform downwards, and then the machine will accurately drill parallel holes from the underside of the cast by pressing the work table, as I just told you, the platform downwards. Once the holes are created, then you're going to cement the double pins with the help of cyanoacrylate cement, or if you're using a plastic sleeves which is placed on the flat end of the double pin, the procedure is repeated for other prepared teeth or teeth. And the thin sheet of utility wax is placed over the tip of the double pin, as we were doing with the help of ball of wax in your straight double pin system, the same thing which you can use here also. And then stone is poured to make the base. After setting the stone, the dies are sectioned with the saw blade, and these dies are then removed by tapping the dowel below the base of the cast. So these are the holes on the working model, that is the base of the cast, and then it becomes easy. You just have to pull the section die above so that you can easily remove the die from the base of the cast. The advantage of Pindex system is that it is a removable die system. It facilitates accurate placement of the die pins. The drawback is you require a special equipment, and that increases the cost of the other type of removable die system is the dialog system. And in this system, you have a special form of plastic tray which is used, which has internal grooves and notches. So once you have poured the full arch impression with die stone, and you allow that the stone to set, and then you remove the cast and you trim it into shape so that it fits into the dialog tray. Then you are going to make a second pour and with this stone into the tray. and you are going to place the cast over the top, over it. After setting off the base of the cast, the tray is disassembled to free the cast. So then the cast is, the die is sectioned with a saw blade till the internal grooves on the cast, and die is broken with a finger pressure. That becomes very easy for you to remove it from the base of the cast. And the process is repeated to separate the other dies from the cast. So the advantage is it is less costly than the Pindex. You don't require special equipment like Pindex system, and it is simple and easy to prepare because you just have to invest into one-time plastic trays, and there is no use, you are not using any kind of double pins here. So that is another advantage. The drawback is it is bulky. It requires more space for mounting on the articulator, and it requires proper maintenance of the parts of the tray for refitting, because chances are that you may have a stone which interlocks into those plastic grooves and notches. So it is important that you clean and maintain, so maintenance is required in this. So these are all the disadvantages of this system. Another system is the AccuTrack system. It is basically the modification of plastic tray with internal grooves and notches. It is used for making working models and dies in laminate veneer cases. So whenever we have a laminate veneer cases, in those cases you can use an AccuTrack system. This technique is similar to the dialogue system which is just described, and the care is taken during sectioning of the die by saw blade, because in veneer cases you have to be very careful with the finish lines. So here the saw cut is made through the interdental papilla, but it is made short, 1 millimeter short of the interproximal finish line. So the die here is broken with finger pressure, as we are doing in the dialogue trays. So this is the same thing which we are doing in AccuTrack system also. The difference here is that you are using specially these system for the laminate veneer cases. So these are all the types of removable die systems which we have just discussed. And here we come to end of our presentation. Thank you for watching the video.